I will be. As I was saying, that I had two parents, and parents make you feel secure. They make you feel that they're always there. They are your security, whether you're a child, whether you're a teenager, whether you're adult, a mother, father, you always have in the back of your mind that my mother or my father is there. Even though you're a big man or woman, as we say, and so mommy held out that role of both parents after daddy died. And she carried it all the way to us into adulthood, to grandchildren. And so I continue feeling right, mommy's there, she's there. Whether what she did, she planted her flowers, whether she decide to sing or give a little dance, whatever. And you continue to feel comfortable that mommy is here, parent is still here. Yeah, I could still talk to her, I could still go to her, or even self. But even when they fall ill, you feel the same way. You're still not thinking that they're ill, or they're not capable of doing the things that they could have done while they were still strong. You still keep feeling that they're there. Mommy's still there. I'm still secure. I'm still protected. And when she fell ill, I still didn't feel that was affected, that security and protection was affected. But when I saw her the night when she passed away, I actually feel my security went. I actually feel my parent went. She left me. Even though she couldn't talk or whatnot, but she used to watch you while you're talking to her. So you knew that she, somewhere inside there, she was understanding you. And I realized at that moment that I have no more parent protection. I have no more parent security. I have no more parents. I'm a child on my own. My parents are all gone. I did love my mother. I respected my mother. Everything that she stand for. I respected the way that she carried herself. The things, the way that she built up herself. Her determination. Her love. In all different ways. This is not going to be easy to forget. She passed away so quietly, so peacefully, so quickly. She didn't give us a chance to say bye. But she's better now. And I'll always respect her. Always respect her.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, for the sake sorrowful passion. Have mercy on us and on the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion. Have mercy on us and on the whole world, for the sake sorrowful passion. Have mercy on us and on the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion. Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Eternal Father,
I'm mercy on us and on the whole world. Sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world.
I offer you the body and the blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus.
For the sake of the soul.
purity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins,
and those of the whole world for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world,
for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world,
for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Mercy on us and on the whole world,
for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world,
for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world,
you know,
for the sake.
We grew up with Granny from
the sorrowful passion.
You know, every day seeing her, love that. And you know, since it happened, and thing, I cried and I tried to hold it in, but it real hard. So I come to tell her, it very hard for it to forget her. You know, sometime in school there was Cecilia, and the first person that called in my mind is Granny, because I'm not accustomed persons call people calling me Cecilia. But now that every time I hear somebody call my name, Granny will be in the back of my mind. But now I work in a high place. Now everybody, I come in face to face with everybody who went, who passed, students, teachers, principals, and I'm feeling like every time somebody call me and ask me, Stephanie, what's going on, it's because Granny will always be there. And it's so hard. I feel like if a part of me left with her, I try to hold strong and all of that, but I just pray to the Lord and ask the Lord every day to give me the strength to go on, because it just hurt, and my chest just hurting me, and I don't know how long it will hurt, because it will be always there. I'd just like to say on behalf of the school, planning it on our parents, teachers, principals, the condolences to everybody. Thanks.
Well, first, you know, I just want to thank everybody that supported us in our time of loss. We want to thank everybody who came and who called. Thank all the grandchildren and the great-grand, the children, all my sister-in-laws for being here. Some of my sister-in-law's family, you know, they came to show their support. All the grandson-in-laws, our neighbor, Miss Merle, mommy, best friend. And You know, it's hard to lose your parent, but I would always say it will hurt me for a very long time, and I know it will hurt a lot of us here, but when you check mommy's life, I know that the beginning of her life, you know, it was rocky when you have children and you're now starting off in life, but coming to the end of her life there, you know, we tried our best to make sure she enjoyed a little of everything. And the things that she liked, like carrying her to buy a rose plant or carrying her for a drive, she just wanted to go for that drive just to have an ice cream. Or she would want a puzzle. Those little things made her happy. She wanted a wood cross book. Mommy, she was always, you know, there for us. No matter how little or what little she had, each one of her children can say that she did help in some way or some form. So there are certain things about mommy that you will never forget. You know, remember some time ago when my brothers and they were talking about how when they were growing up, she wasn't easy. You couldn't make mischief and get away. She cut and tail. She pelting them with anything she washing with, you know. But all in all, she loved her children, and she took pride in everything she did, and even in taking care of us. And she did try her best. And mommy will always hold a special place in my heart, because, you know, she always wanted to be independent and she wanted to be on her own and live by herself. And for the past 12 or 13 years, you know, when she started to live with me, you know, I learned so much more from her and learned about her. We had our quarrels, we used to have a little noise, you know, she always wanted to do things her way. But, you know, at the end of the day, she was mother. And sometimes I used to realize after, you know, what she's saying is really the truth, eh? So I had to accept that. But, you know, sometimes you can't tell her because she would say, you see what I was telling you all the time. But mommy was a really nice person to us, to her children, to her grandchildren. She even, her great-grand, she had a little input in the upbringing of her great-grand. And Celine had real fun times with her, jokes. Her neighbors, our neighbors are wrong, you know. She always pleasant and smiling. So I have good memories of mommy. The last 2 years was a bit rough. It was tough, but I know she was going through a lot. And around Christmas time, I know I was in the bedroom with her day, you know, and I was tidying her and thing, and I said, mommy, I want you to know that whenever you are ready to go, because I was seeing little things, you know, signs with her and thing, I say, I want you to know that we will be okay, you know. We will be okay. And the night before mommy died, the Sunday night, around 6:30, I went into the bedroom to feed her. And mommy opened her eyes so bright, really, really bright. Mommy had small eyes. I've never seen my mommy's eyes so bright and big. And she opened those eyes and she stared at me. She turned the head and she keeps saying, mommy, why are you looking at me like that? I said, girl, I don't like how you're looking at me, you know. But, you know, I just laugh it off. But I realized the next day, you know, what was coming. But those bright eyes, that Sunday night, I really wasn't expecting that it would have happened so soon. But I thank God for the time that I had with her. I thank God for the memories that we made. And I thank God for all the loving people Mommy had around her. Not forgetting Peter. Peter was like a son to her. Peter, he was always around her. Mom, how you going? Checking up on her and assisting in whatever way. And all my family, my sister-in-law, my sister Cheryl, my brothers, all my nieces and my nephews, I thank everybody, all her friends, Miss Mai, Miss Maureen, and all her nieces. She had some favorite ones. They would always call and check up on her. So I just want to thank everybody for being part of Mom's life and for, you know, all the good things that you all did, all the happy times. You know, some of them I will hear on the phone talking to the neighbors and the three of them on the phone there. And she laughing and they carrying on. So I know that she had our people around her that made her happy. And I think that was what was important to her to the end, that she had people around her there for her, to take care of her, and to always bring a smile to her face. So I'm going to miss Mommy so much, you know, especially when I'm passing by that bedroom. But I know she's in a better place. And I will love her, as I used to tell her, Mama, I will love you always and forever. Always and forever. And she just used to smile. So, Mommy, rest easy. And I want you to know that I will always hold our special memories. I will love you, and I will never forget you. And the children, Dario and Celine, my two soldiers, you know, they stood by me. And I thank God for having them around me. I thank God for them. So, Mommy, I know you're in a better place. And I thank God for you every day. Every day. Now that you are gone, and I know you are with him. So, until we meet again,
good afternoon, everyone. My name is Donna Da Costa Martinez. I'm one of Auntie's eldest, I think the eldest niece, I'm the eldest niece. I'm the daughter of her deceased brother, Cyril Da Costa. I know we've come here today under very difficult circumstances, but I think it's also a very joyous occasion to give thanks, and also to give thanks for Auntie's life and the part that she played in all of our development. As one of the eldest children, I always remember the days when we would go to Flanagan Town during the Christmas season. And we really look forward to that time because we had a very strict dad. And the only time we would get time out is at Christmas to visit my grandmother, Dorothy, and to see and to be with Auntie Celia. I want to say that this woman is such a beautiful person and had such a kind heart that nothing was difficult for her to do for us like she did for her children. She fed us as if she were feeding her own children. I think I got a few. I heard you this morning, Roxanne, when you spoke about her skills in sewing. I think I also benefited from that opportunity as well, with Auntie making some kind of blouse or something for me. So I stand here today to say that I know she's going in the right place because of all that she did for all her nieces and nephews as we grew up. I want to say this on behalf of all my siblings, that we really do value and cherish the times that we spend together. I want to also, I know my cousins Carol and Sandra in particular are hurting deeply because they had made a commitment that anybody in the family died, that they would be here. But these are very difficult circumstances that we're living under, very hard times. And we need to be very careful. But I want to say that some of the best memories I have is being with Cheryl. Roxanne was the doll that we played with at Christmas time. But singing, lying in my grandmother's bed, and singing Christmas carols, and Auntie there joining in with us, and looking at after our every need. These are not things that you ever forget. We may not speak about them often, but they're certainly things that remain in our hearts. And she will always be remembered for those kind acts. So once again, I know, and I want to say to my cousins, I know you are paining. I know it is a difficult time. But I ask that you cherish the fond memories and keep those in your heart, and at least you will be able to cope with her passing even better. Just thinking back of all that she has done, thinking back of the fun times, thinking back about the fact that we didn't live in elaborate houses and yet we had so much joy as children. Yet we were able to experience the good life from the country. So again, I say, we hold you, my brothers Ricardo, Michael, my sisters, Anne-Marie, Debbie, Lynette, and Linan. We have a deceased sister, Claire. She's passed on. But I know I stand here to say that on behalf of them, we will always cherish the good times and the love that we had for her. I thank you very much.
Stood in another land, trying to buy that last gift or two, not really in the Christmas mood. Standing right in front of me was a little boy waiting anxiously, pacing round like little boys do, and in his hands he held a pair of shoes, and his clothes were worn and old. He was dirty from head to toe. And when it came his time to pay, I couldn't believe what I heard him say. Sir, I wanna buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes will make her smile. And I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. They counted pennies for what seemed like years. Then the cashier said, son, there's not enough here. He searched his pockets frantically. Then he turned and he looked at me. He said, Mama made Christmas good at our house, though most years she just did without. Tell me, sir, what am I gonna do? Somehow I've gotta buy her these Christmas shoes. So I laid the money down. I just had to help him out. And I'll never forget the look on his face when he said, Mama's gonna look so great. Sir, I wanna buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes will make her smile. Want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. There's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes will make her smile. And I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight.
I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus.
me if heaven has a garden. Could you take my mama there? Walk her slowly to your flower bed. Pick her roses for all the wars unsaid. Kiss her gently on her soft cheek. Carry her if her legs are weak. Please tell her I'm okay down here. Does she see me? Can she hear? I've heard heaven has a garden with angels singing on a cloudy bandstand. Up in heaven in that garden, won't you take my mama there? She left me with memories made of gold. Her gentle love was a wonder to behold. Ask her to sing her favorite song from way down here. I'll sing along.
Thank you. some